and welcome to part two of the Ask a Farrinarian series on colic in horses. I'm Dr. Brian. In this episode, we'll go over the treatment and management of colic in horses. So make sure you check out part one, as the treatment makes a lot more sense when you understand the problem. Also, another quick plug for our other video on colic to help you recognize colic in your horse, as well as what to do and what not to do while you're waiting for a vet. Now, with very few exceptions, every horse needs to be seen by a vet every time it's suspected of colicking. That's a big statement, and it's true regardless of your horse experience, and here's why. One, colics can be very deceiving. The quiet ones can be critical, and the dramatic ones can actually be relatively minor. Two, caught and treated early, most colics resolve easily. 1 to 2 visits, and they're back off doing normal horse stuff. And third, it doesn't take very long to go from simple complicated and life-threatening. I know it's super frustrating to pay an emergency bill because your horse was just a little crampy. There's actually a lot of peace of mind from knowing, okay, that's all it is, and survival rates drop, and the bills can get huge when you have to treat a horse for days and days because they developed a severe impaction while you're hoping they'd get through their cramps. That brings us nicely to how we actually treat colic in horses. There's not much secret here. It's mostly hydration and pain management. So we'll start with hydration. I talked a lot about it in part one, but that's because it's so important, and also why just giving your horse some pain meds usually isn't enough. Whether a horse is dehydrated at the beginning or it will become so because it doesn't feel well enough to drink right, every horse needs help staying hydrated. So we do that most often by passing a nasogastric tube. The first step is assessing what's in the stomach. And when I pass an NG tube, I'm really hoping that I don't get anything back out of the tube because the stomach's empty. If the stomach's empty, that means that everything is still moving along, or the problem is far enough down the pipe that it just hasn't had time to back up into the stomach yet. An empty stomach means that I can still give fluids orally, and that's optimal. I can give more volume into a horse faster and keep it there longer than with IV alone. A big drink of water can also help stimulate intestinal motility, like after a big meal. And I can rehydrate impactions better and cheaper than with IV alone. I'll also typically add electrolytes because the horse usually is in need of them, and the salt component can help them, can help encourage them to drink better on their own. I'll also usually add mineral oil. For me, the mineral oil mostly serves as a marker, but can have a laxative effect. If I can get mineral oil out the back end, that means that the pipe is at least partially open and moving along. They can still have plenty of gas and manure past the point of the problem. So, it's okay, he farted, or yay, she pooped, doesn't mean we're necessarily in the clear. Also, because I know when I gave the mineral oil, it serves to tell me how fast things are moving along. However, let's go back to that first step with the NG tube. If I get a bunch of rancid fluid or old feed material back, that means that nothing's getting past the stomach. This is a pretty good indicator that we're dealing with a more serious colic, and I now have to rely on IV fluids alone for that key hydration role, because adding anything into the stomach just makes things worse. Now, IV fluids are a great tool, but they're expensive, they're slow, and really they need to be done in a hospital to be done sufficiently. How your horse responds to pain meds is also really helpful in determining how serious a situation we have. It's a great sign when your horse goes from rolling and painful to wanting to eat about 10-15 minutes after I give him some IV Vanamine. The minor colics tend to feel dramatically better with pain meds. The severe colics are compromised enough that either they don't process the pain meds right, or they're in too much pain for the pain meds to control. The good news is that most colics can be managed right there on the farm, and with prompt and appropriate treatment, most will do just fine. Short-term management, again, typically involves pain management to keep them from hurting themselves, enough water to hydrate them and keep them that way, and trying to make sure they feel good enough so that they'll drink on their own. If a horse will drink on their own, most of them are in the clear. Long-term management involves looking more at the lifestyle and habits of you and your horse to see if there's a way to prevent this situation in the future. That brings us to the end of part two. I hope you're now experts in colic. If you learned something, please share it and help others too. And as always, thanks for watching.